You are watching Skyrim commentary from Shauna Films.
I want to say we're heading. We're heading west. Oh yeah, we're going to Bleak Falls Barrow. Who's this guy?
You there, citizen. This area is off limits.
Once again, I'm in the dark, without a torch, can't see squat.
Yeah, so you'll
YouTube's gonna scream at me for
fine.
Uploading a dark video. Coin,
you'll pay with your life.
Now, I'm gonna break your top.
Why is he just standing there? Well, that was lame. Why were the NPCs just standing there? Why weren't they fighting us? Right. Make sure everyone's with us. Come on, get over here. Where are you? Oh, there you are.
We should keep moving.
Yes, we should.
Mm-hmm. Skjor says that I have the strength of Ysgrimor. I'll show you what I can about protecting yourself.
Oh, yeah. Whenever I got money, I could always have him train me, since he's with us at the time. Okay, who's up here this time?
Didn't I tell you I was good?
I thought there was something down here on the ground. Oh, there it is. Oh, I just ran past something. So we're going to Bleak Falls Barrow. I've got one of the companions with me. We're supposed to be going to Dustman's Carn, but nope. There's no weird saber cats or wolves or anything around here because I'm using True Hunter and it removes all the animals from Skyrim. It removes like 90% of the animals. Apparently it leaves skeevers in the game though. So when you, because before, you know, you'd walk like 10 feet, there'd be a bear. Then you walk 10 more feet, there'd be another bear. Then you walk 10 more feet, there's a saber cat. It was like Skyrim Zoo. Now when you see a bear or a saber cat, it's a rare luxury item that you probably have to kill if you need claws or eyeballs or pelt. So now you really have to hunt for bears to get 10 bear pelts for that, you know, Armstrong lady. Strong arm or Armstrong, whatever it is. And there's usually a troll here, which isn't. It removes. You know, True Hunter removes trolls from the game.
Wouldn't it be nice to just talk a little, you and I?
So animals don't just spawn in the same place all the time. You know, it's predictable. You just turn your head around and there's a troll right there, you know.
It's so nice to just talk a little, you and I. I was just thinking, would you be interested if I told you a little about myself?
Oh well. I obviously cannot force you.
So I thought I'd say no to her and see if she skips over those things. But no, she just cues them because she's going to tell you about her life story no matter what. Even if you keep saying no to her. Even when you say we've done all these quests and you're married to her and everything, she still wants to tell you her backstory. It's kind of cute, but kind of annoying at the same time. Yeah, so running up here, I don't have to think, oh yeah, we can kill a saber cat, we can get a troll, we can get some wolves, and kill some elk on the way up here. No, that You can't metagame like that anymore because those things are gone from the game. If you see anything in the game, like I said, it's a luxury item. Something that should be worshipped instead of killed on sight. Or you can just kill it. And then hope you see another bear in your playthrough. Because you probably won't.
Go get her! I'm gonna nail her with my arrow.
Get who? Oh, she was... Oh, I didn't know about this, but the bandits from the other fort were ambushing us from behind. I don't know how they saw us. Because we didn't come from that direction. So they're busy fighting people from another fort. I'm trying to sneak up on this Bleak Falls Barrow, and they've already massacred people from the other place overlooking Riverwood. These guys, I think, are just strays. They probably were just spawned between Bleak Falls Barrow and the fort over yonder. So I think we ended up going to the fort anyway, just to double check. Oh yeah, they're dead. There's a troll here too that's missing. Just as well. That's so annoying when you got trolls that close to Riverwood. It just doesn't make sense. Oh, you missed.
You see?
What was that all about? You're my shield
can
sibling.
Can beat me? Go ahead.
He must have tapped him with the sword, and he just kind of volunteered to die at his feet. So the reason why I'm walking slow is hypothermia is making me go slow in the snow. I used to have wet and cold installed that would do the same thing. Speaking of which, I'll be putting wet and cold back in my game since it works with hypothermia. I'll just use hypothermia to control my running speed during blizzards. Just more things to turn off in wet and cold. I just want I just want the stupid backpacks and the cloaks from wet and cold, and I want the goggles and things when you're in a sandstorm or a dust storm, ash storm, yeah, ash storms over at Solstice. That's all I want. And I like the breath coming out of my mouth when it's freezing ass cold. That's always cool. Now, I like the water dripping from me when I come out of the water. And what else do I like about wet and cold? Now, I'm going to use the feature where it sends civilians home during a rain or snowstorm, because I'm a glutton for punishment. Because in the past, what wet and cold will do is it sends people on horses to the tavern when there's a blizzard. And then you have horses inside the taverns. So I'm curious if that's going to happen in my playthrough. I know if you have holidays installed, that for sure happens. And you end up with guys on horses walking through your holds. Because they're there to celebrate. You know, there's a holiday going on in the town. I saw these weird things up on the cliff here, because I know my Skyrim really well, and I know when I see something's changed. It's like, what is that up there? It looks like a Nordic ruin up on the top of this hill. Never seen that before. Of course, I'm doing it the wrong way. I didn't know there were stairs leading up to this place. But then I found this thing. Like, what is this? It's from Winter sun? The faith of Skyrim? So that's neat. I think it's cool when I find these little things. Unfortunately, the person who makes these mods is crappy at making assets and putting them in the game. They just slap it all in there. It's Clipville, Clip City. You know, nothing seems to match. It doesn't look blended in very well. It's just, oh, here you go. Let me just, you know, throw this hodgepodge in. At least, I want to say at least, no, maybe not. The stuff isn't nav meshed at all. So, that's another thumbs down for this guy's mods. There's no nav mesh for anything. Because those two would have come up to greet me. But no, they just stood here. They're like, how did he get up there? Now maybe technically an NPC can't climb a hill that steep. Still, you can tell the nav mesh to get NPCs' asses up there. To be up there with you. Maybe even put some idols up there too, so when a companion's standing there with you, they're doing that animation where they're sightseeing, like they're holding their hand up, you know, above their face to keep the sun out as they look over the horizon from that vantage point. You know, stuff like that. Why did I get cold all of a sudden? What was that all about? Oh, you're freezing too? Okay, good. It's just not me. I did go up higher than them, so I probably got colder than them. But now I'm about the same temperature as them, I suppose. Blue. My temperature is blue. I was having troubles getting meditate to work. And I didn't know what it was. I didn't know what it was, but eventually I figured out that my meditate button got moved over by another mod I installed. Because I usually hit the middle mouse button, and that wasn't doing anything in my game, as it turned out. So I had to reprogram my middle mouse button. My middle finger button. And then I was able to meditate and do shouts and all that kind of stuff again. I don't use the Z button at all on my keyboard. Or whatever that mod made my meditation. It's the button for doing shouts and powers and something else, I forget. Something nasty, probably.
A Nordic ruin. What say you?
Well, we're finally here. It's pitch black almost. I can see my silhouette, so that's something. I'm gonna put first person view back in my game. What is that called? Enhanced camera? 1.4? I'm gonna put that back in my game soon. Because I want to be in first-person mode when I'm riding a horse or when I'm a werewolf, you know, that kind of thing. It's annoying trying to be a werewolf and you're stuck in third-person.
Let's see what you got.
Did I stretch?
Let's see what you... Ah! Oh, someone's hit.
No match at all.
Now these guys are what, level 3, level 4? So that's why they're falling over really easy. I want to say Vilya is level 10 when you first meet her. Some people panic when they look at her stats and she stays at level 10 throughout the entire playthrough. But she's using her own level calculations. She's not using vanilla level stats. Come on, you guys. I don't know if I like this I don't know if I like that frost effect that shows up when I hit people with this thing. It looks different than the frost that's on me when I'm cold. You know, like what's on Vilya there. Did I say Lydia before? I meant Vilya. See, I like it when I'm cold and I start getting snow on me. I like that look. But when I look like I'm covered in gelatinous slime, I don't like that look for cold. So I don't know if that's a vanilla thing, or if I've installed a mod for enchanted weapons that adds that effect. You know, like Wildcat might be adding that effect to my NPCs when I hit them with my frost stick. Like, I don't use Apocalypse anymore, and I don't use the Winter Mist anymore. Or is it Summer Mist? I don't use those anymore because they change the effect of spells, and I don't like how they look. And plus, they add so many more effects and spells to the game. It's just too much. It's just mind-numbing. The amount of spells that those mods add to the game. And their names for all their different little poisons and everything. And all the enchantments are renamed to something else. It's just too much. I'm just this guy. I'm just a criminal who was being sent to Helgen. I'm not some sort of a PhD in magic science who knows the meanings of every little what was I doing here? Oh, I was looking at the dust coming down. I think I forgot to install one of my dust mods, mist mods, snow mods. You know, the animated texture stuff that goes on in caves and dungeons. I was trying someone else's dust mod because they were bragging about how awesome it was, but indoors, I didn't much care for it indoors. Outdoors, it looked good. So I just have to separate his mods from someone else's so I can use both dust mods from both mod authors. Because apparently when the giant hits the ground with his club, there's dust that comes up in the air. And I haven't decided yet whose dust mod I like for that animation. Come on, you guys. I guess it's too dark for the NPCs to see us. Or for my companions to see them. I don't have a darkness mod installed, per se. I'm not using immersive NPC in the dark. I used to use that mod all the time. That's the mod that gives out torches to NPCs to help them see in the dark. And then you end up with everyone inside the taverns with torches, walking around with torches inside taverns. Drives me nuts. But I liked it when it did work. And it would give out wearable lanterns to NPCs also. Which was cool. So it wasn't always a torch that they'd have. Sometimes they would just have a lantern that they would equip so they can see in the dungeon. Because they're exploring just like you are. For stuff. NPCs will see a chest, they'll open it, grab a weapon, and come at you with it. That's kind of cool. And I noticed that's been happening.
I'm so glad that we're traveling to Eldegreen Sanctuary together.
I'm trying to see if my hands would raise up in the fire to warm myself, but I'm guessing I'm already warmed up. I I was getting reacquainted with hypothermia because I haven't used that mod in a couple years. I have been using... I've been using wet and cold, I guess, for a couple years. Alongside Immersive Citizens AI Overhaul. Those two mods work pretty well together. Because they both sort of turn off each other's stuff. And I've got Get Snowy. I use Get Snowy for my frost texture on everybody when they're outside freezing to death. Anyway, so I got this customizable camera. And you guys at home can watch me configure it so that I get my camera to go over, kind of over my right elbow instead of the camera being directly in the back of my neck all the time. So what else is going on in Skyrim? Anything exciting? There's always... See, now when I zoom in, zoom out, I'm sort of standing off to the left there. So that's better. We're getting there. Oh, I'm a little bit... If I'm too close to the camera, I'll turn invisible. Each weapon you draw has its own camera settings, so whatever I set for bow and axe and such, I gotta make sure they all match. And then I change them all again when I realize I've got something on, like a cloak or a backpack, something that's hitting the camera and making me turn invisible. But it doesn't take long to make the adjustments here. It's easy peasy. And when I reinstall Skyrim Enhanced Camera 1.4, I'll probably have to do this over again. Because the final zoom is when you go to first person. Maybe I won't have to touch this mod again after installing the first person mod. But I like using the vanilla, what do they call it, the aiming mechanics of vanilla, because the dot on the screen is where the stuff is going to go. In other first-person mods, you have to tweak where that dot on the screen is actually aiming at, so that arrows and things actually go there. I'm too old to be tweaking around with that kind of nonsense. I just want to play Skyrim when I get home from work. I don't want to play Configure Skyrim. Or let's do a let's play of Skyrim configuration all night. Yeah, I don't want to be that person. Here I sort of messed up. I wanted to shoot this guy, but I guess I missed. And then anyway. I was seeing if I could hit him when the dot is behind my elbow. And I can't exactly see. Oh, see? I remember now. You can't kill a guy if he's doing his animation. But once his animation was over, then he started to die from the poisoned arrow I gave him. That was kind of neat. But he was going to open that door no matter what. Once he starts walking towards it, he's pretty much dedicated to finishing his animation first before he dies. And these skeevers, I don't even see them coming at me. I used to be able to see skeevers come at me, but I guess the new textures I gave them, they don't have any shine to them, or they don't have any ambience to them or something. Strange. They're just dark. Because usually I spot them a mile away. Same for wolves. I don't really see wolves anymore in my game in the dark until they're right on me. Which is kind of cool, because before I used to spot the wolves right away. I mean, my skeevers have these pink noses and feet, but that doesn't seem to help. By the time you see their noses and feet, it's too late, they're already on you. Oh, it's starting to hail outside. Cool. Wow, that means it's snowing in the mountains somewhere. If it's hailing in the desert. All hail the desert. You know, the ground gets covered in little ice cubes that melt after about a minute. That's what it's looking like outside now. As long as they remain small ice cubes, I don't want my car windshield smashed in by chunks of ice rock from space. But I guess over a couple thousand miles from here is where the storms get even worse and people get buried in snow and other things. How do I get down there? Is that a thing in the game? I'm guessing.
Over here.
I guess I go down there later on in this dungeon, right?
You did it. You killed it. Now cut me down before anything else shows up.
I always forget to look to see where that is exactly down there.
You'll never get the claw. Yeah. It's coming loose.
But anyway, that was one of the first times a spider fell down that thing.
Why should I share the treasure with anyone?
Oh, I remember this part. This is when I didn't much care for the vanilla spiderwebs in the game, so I put modded spiderwebs in the game. I want to watch this guy fight some Draugr.
I knew it.
He's actually doing pretty good. Oh. Oh well. Anyway, so he's got these spiderwebs on him. And it looked like slime to me. It looked like someone spit or drooled on him constantly. So that's when I decided to add a web texture to the game. So now he looks like he's covered in webs instead of slime. Just little things like that. Doesn't take up an ESP slot, so what the heck. I'll do it. I try to perk up whatever it was I was doing at the time. I leveled up. Why not? What the heck? Maybe that starts a vicious cycle where you're just constantly perking up things that you're, you know, skills that you're leveling up in. And it has like a snowball effect, but technically you don't level up as much in the skills as you level up in skills, you level up slowly in those same skills. You know, it's not linear. As it should be from the beginnings of time. Leveling was not meant to be linear. Like going from level 1 to 2 is easy. Going from 2 to 3 is almost as easy. Going to level 3 to 4 is almost as easy as 2 to 3 was, you know, that kind of thing. And then eventually getting from level 99 to level 100 should be nearly impossible. But a lot of gamers don't understand that. They don't know what that concept even is. And you try to explain it to them and they just don't get it. They don't. It's like you got two kinds of players when it comes to tabletop role-playing games, which is what all this comes from. D&D type stuff. D&D uses a D20 die. Other role-playing games use two six-sided dice. And there's a hell of a lot of difference between rolling two six-sided dice and rolling one 20-sided die. Huge-ass difference. So different that the game mechanics are different for those dice. But most so-called tabletop role players, they don't understand. They just don't get the idea. They don't know how dice work to begin with, so they're playing a dice game and they don't know how dice work. That's scary thought. Scary thoughts.
I'm gonna cleave you with my sword. Did I scratch your pretty face?
See, why is everyone's turning into this gelatinous goo when I hit him with this thing? It's supposed to freeze them?
No,
it's gotta be Wildcat that's doing that to them. Because I don't remember Vanilla ever looking that way in my game.
It's my sword.
Or I've got another mod, maybe, that's doing the effect. They almost look like ghosts when I hit them. I'm gonna have to watch a previous
we should keep moving.
YouTube video of mine to see protecting yourself. What NPCs look like when I hit them with the frost stick before I reinstalled. See, this is stuff I noticed after I reinstalled Skyrim from scratch. For all I know, it's always been a thing, but just because I'm all paranoid now because I reinstalled Skyrim, I start noticing things. Okay, like the eyes in the Draugr, they're fixed. They weren't ever fixed in my playthroughs. I always had the little trailing glow eyes would continue to stay trailing glow after killing a Draugr. Now when I kill a Draugr, the trailing glow goes back inside their skull as their eyeball shuts off. Because they're dead, right? So their eyes shut down, so their little headlight beams shut down. That wasn't happening before in my playthroughs. Until now. Because I'm using a, what do they call it? I guess I'm using a Draugr retexture mod that also fixes their eyeballs. And this is bugging me. This giant spider egg name, there's a space in front of the giant. Oh, that bugs me to no end. The guy who made, Alchemy Vocabulary. It's a really cool mod. But, he put a space in front of giant spider egg. I don't like it.
You are as good as dead. You're as good as dead. You're a creep. You're as good as dead.
God, now it's really pouring rain. Rain and hail and who knows what else. I was going to do laundry today. I may have to put that on hold. Because I have to walk outside. Boo-hoo. Driscoll has to walk outside to do his laundry. Already people are thinking about how when they were kids and they had to walk 10 miles in the snow naked to get to school each morning. To that I say, and your point? I said that to some kids earlier this week. They were complaining about something and I said, well, I had to walk in the snow naked. I don't know why I had the naked part. And they're like, ew. TMI. And I'm like, oh, maybe I shouldn't be saying the naked part.
You made a big mistake. We are good.
I don't know when that started. Because when I was a kid, I was always told by everybody how they had to walk, you know, 10 miles through 10 feet of snow every morning to get to school. Blah, blah, blah. But then the naked part showed up. I don't know. Maybe I just thought that was funny when I was a kid. Because they would tell me the story all the time, and I was just tired of hearing it. And I would just add the naked part after they'd say whatever they'd say. And they would say, no, I wasn't naked. And then they'd start thinking about it. Was I naked? And then movies started coming out where guys are running around naked in the snow around that same time. When they were popular movies. Oh, what were those movies called? See, that's driving me crazy with the giant spider egg and the space in front of there. I had to go fix it right away because it was just driving me nuts. Okay, I fixed it. I just went into the editor and deleted the space that was in front of the name. Okay. Millions of lives are... Oh. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. Eating stuff, I don't know what... Ooh. The glowy things make me electrified. Anyway. What was I talking about? Oh yeah, being naked and afraid. Everything's naked now on TV, have you noticed? Oh, Rich, that reminds me, I need to watch, season one of... Westworld,
that's
I finally...
Strange.
Oh! Get up! Get up! Saved by one health point. I want to watch, season one of Westworld. I saw the pilot episode. And I liked what I saw. And then I heard all about the TV series, so I sort of waited a while before I bought the season one. Because now I've forgotten what the show's even about and who's in it. So some of it will be a shock to me, maybe, as I watch the season. At first, I didn't want to spend money on the show because some of the actors and actresses are, you know, they're leftists. They're far left-wing leftists. You know, which is what mostly Hollywood is these days. So I'm sort of picky on what I spend my money on for Am I supporting a leftist regime kind of a thing by buying this DVD? Stuff like that. Then the actors will tell you that they don't make money on the DVDs. So I was like, okay, I'll buy a DVD then. What the heck? They got paid already by the studio. They're already doing other projects now. I've memorized this door. You just click on each ring twice, and that's how you solve it. You don't have to look at the claw to see what the solution is. Just click each ring twice. Done. There should be a mod that randomizes the doors so you don't have, so you can't just walk up to them and do what I just did. You have to look at the claw to see what the combination is. Maybe either the claw will have a different combination on it, or the door will be scrambled differently each time. That's what the mod would have to do. Scrambled door locks, something like that. Or scrambled dragon claws. Keys. Scrambled keys on dragon claws, something like that. So people like me that have played these things forever can't just do stuff without looking at the key code. Oh, I can't do a shout yet. Oops.
You think you can beat me? Go ahead.
It's always hit or miss with this scene here. I'm always messing it up. I forget that my companions like to run directly in front of me when I'm aiming my arrow.
Yes?
And at this level, I can't move very fast while I'm aiming my arrow. I can't move at all, probably. So, I can't get a better shot while I'm aiming with my arrow. And I can't turn at all while I'm aiming my arrow. So I'm basically just wasting.
Shall we continue?
Wasting. What's the word? I'm just idling, I guess. That's all I'm doing. I'm just idling while my companions figure out how to kill something ahead of me. I'm always paranoid there's going to be something on the other side of this door to kill me, but I don't have immersive creatures installed, which usually adds like 3 Draugr over here to ambush me. Or Revenge of the Enemies, that's a really cool mod that adds everything you can think of as a boss fight, but I hate boss fights, so I don't use it.